Hey everyone, it's Andy Pease in Balanced Green Consulting. We're here at the Los Robles House out in beautiful San Luis Obispo, and we're here today to talk to Mike Horgan, our builder, about a mock-up and the wall assembly. So let's turn it over to Mike. So Mike, tell us first why you do a mock-up, and then I'm hoping you can just kind of quickly walk us through the pieces of the wall assembly.
So why do we do a mock-up? Well, we have a few different crews working on this project, and I feel like carpenters and builders are very kinetic learners. So as opposed to putting things on paper, architects love to put things on paper, a lot gets lost in transition. If there's ever a question about anything, we can just point right to it. Most everybody will be able to walk right over to it and say, oh, that's how it's supposed to look? Okay.
Okay, so Mike, can you go ahead and just like walk us through the layers of what this wall assembly is going to be made up of?
Yep, sure. So it's a fairly conventional wall assembly. A few things look a little bit different, but we've got 2x6 dug for framing. That will eventually get filled with a blown-in cellulose on the inside cavity. After we have our, we went with CDX wood sheathing versus OSB. OSB is actually a little bit more expensive than CDX right now, which is very unusual. Outside of the CDX, we went with a self-adhered WRB, that's our weather-resistant barrier. There are many different WRBs in the market. We went with this one for a few different reasons. We'll have a whole series on that afterwards. It's a peel-and-stick, self-adhesive. Hannah and I wrapped this whole house in probably a total of 6 or 8 hours with a bunch of goofing around in between. So we have our WRB. Outside the WRB, we have our wood fiber insulation. So we're trying to be really conscious of our carbon footprint, our embodied as well as our operating. So instead of foam, we're gonna use a wood fiber here. We have a flashing system that I've outlined. We have furring strips on the outside of our wood fiber insulation to give us a continuous half inch air gap. That gap will run from the sill all the way through the roof actually and exit out the high point of the roofs. And then on top of our furring strips, we are going with a redwood siding. This is going to be TNG. This is just a straight 1x6 right now. So that is our wall mock-up.
And then can you just point to the taping up at the underside there? So you're getting a continuous air seal for this whole thing.
Yeah, so a big reason for doing mock-ups like this is to show the crews the transition points. So sill plate to the wall, walls to windows, windows to roofs. So this one is particularly valuable to us so that the framers can see how we've built in a continuous air gap that's gonna go behind our blocking. They'll have a sill vent in our eaves, and then our air will flow behind our blocking and up through, which you can feel, and they can see a 2x4 air gap that we're gonna build on top of the roof member.
Awesome, thanks.